أدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. فاللهم صل على محمد في الأولين، وصل على محمد في الآخرين، وصل على محمد في كل وقت وحين، وصل على محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. First of all, before I start anything, for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, I am asking you by the great name of Allah, do always the best of your dua to me, inshaAllah. Do the best of your dua for me and for my family. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from all of us and to make it easy for us. Ameen, ya Rabbal Alameen. And to admit us to Jannah. Ameen, ya Rabbal Alameen. And to save us from an-nar. And to accept our own good deeds, ya Rabbal Alameen. Ameen. Always remember me in your dua, inshaAllah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, dua of the brother to his brother in his absence is acceptable. For that your dua for me, inshaAllah, and for your own self is acceptable, inshaAllah. Now if you look here, inshaAllah, this is, we'll talk about al-mad. What is al-mad? Lengthening. Lengthening. And al-mad or lengthening is part of التجويد. التجويد هو it is إعطاء الحرف حقه ومستحقه صفة ومخرجا ومدا. Means giving every letter. If you concentrate with the definition of التجويد, what is التجويد? Giving every letter, every حرف letter, the right of it, from the qualities of it, and from the مخرج. Makhraj is from where the letter get out. How you pronounce it right. How instead of ain, you say ayn. Or instead of alhamdu, some people say alhamdu. It is wrong, alhamdu. Because the qualities of the letter and the makhraj is very important to know from where the makhraj. And also one of it, part of it is al-mad, which it is our topic today, al-mad. The mad of it, the lengthings, how to make it longer and how much is it. وهو means التجويد لصون اللسان عن الخطأ. In order to protect your tongue and protect yourself, protect your record, actually the text says اللسان, the tongue, from committing any mistake. In order to save yourself from committing any mistake. لتجنب اللحن الخفي والجلي. To avoid any mistake, the clear one and the hidden one. There is some of it is clear, like the fatha, kasra, dhamma, and some of it is hidden one also. Some of it also, like if you make mistake, if it is izhar, you make it idgham, idgham, you make it ikhfa, ikhfa, you make it ikhlab, this is all of it wrong. You have to know, and it takes time. Like anything in the whole world, it takes time to learn it. For that, giving the letter the right of it, in order to say it with the qualities of it, and from the makhraj, the place of getting out of it, and the mad of it, protect your tongue from committing wrong. Reading also, as I told you the last time, as one ways of the recitation of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the rules of it also, all of it. And also to avoid all kind of mistakes, the small one, the big one, the hidden one, the clear one. Listen, وَالْعَمَلُ بِهِ فَرْضُ عَيْنِ. To do according to it, and to recite with it, it is فَرْضُ عَيْنِ. فَرْضُ عَيْنِ means obligatory upon you. Upon every individual to learn it and to apply it, and step by step, neglecting it is not right in Islam. This is the part, this is the tajweed itself in general. Now we are talking about al-mad. Al-mad huwa, what it is al-mad? Al-ziyada. Increasing the timing of letter. Ziyada is increasing the timing of pronouncing the letter itself. Which it is, look here, please. Alif, or waw, or ya. This is the letters of al-mad. This is the letters of al-mad. Alif, or waw, or ya. Al-ziyada increasing, as look here, lengthening, same meaning. Lengthening, increasing. Italatu sawti biharf al-mad. Lengthening the voice and the pronouncing the letter with the pronouncing with the letter of the mad. What is the letters of al-mad? Alif, or waw, or ya. This is the only three letters of al-mad. Alif, or waw, or ya. حروف اللين is waw and ya only. And we'll explain it, inshallah. But the mad alif or waw or ya. Just try to learn what I'm giving you now until inshallah we'll go more, and with the applying and with more details you will get, and you have to see it, and you should see it more than one time in order to get more information inshallah. Repeat it for yourself. Now, how many types of al-mad? The types of al-mad. Number one, tabi'i, natural. Tabi'i, natural. Sometimes they name asli, same name. Tabi'i or asli, original. Sometimes they name dhati, self. It is tabi'i, natural, original. Tabi'i, try to know the word. Tabi'i. The second one, far'i, which it is secondary. The far'i number two, secondary. For that, this is the types of al-mad. And this is a big types of it. Because under the tabi'i there is some, and under also the far'i there is some. The tabi'i under it there is two, main one, with it will be three. With the tabi'i itself, one, another two under it. Under the far'i there is 10 different kinds. Under the far'i with the secondary there is 10 different kinds. Then now, what is the tabi'i? What is the natural? What is the original? هو الذي لا يتوقف على سبب من همز أو سكون. The reason of it is not the hamza, not the sukun. The reason of it is not the hamza, is not the sukun. With another way. Like the alif, or the waw, or the ya, does not have before it, does not have after it hamza or sukun. This will be tabi'i. Waw does not have before it, does not have after it hamza or sukun. Suppose no hamza here, no hamza here. Also no sukun here, behind. Yeah, does not have hamza or sukun before or after. This will be tabi'i. Example of that, look here. Nu, hi, ha. Look to the red color. Nu, is here the waw, itself is second. And before it dhamma. Nu, nu, hi. The ya itself is second and before the kasra. Nuhi ha. The alif itself is second, but before it fatha. For that the waw preceded by dhamma, or the ya preceded by kasra, or the ha, or the alif, I'm sorry, preceded by fatha. Why dhamma kasra? Dhamma because the one suitable for the waw is the dhamma. The one suitable for the lengthening of the ya is the kasra. The one suitable for the lengthening, the make it longer of the alif is the fatha. Another example. Look here, please. U-ti-na. This waw mad tabi'i. This ya mad tabi'i. This alif mad tabi'i. Like here. This waw mad tabi'i. This ya is mad tabi'i. This alif is a mad tabi'i. Here is the same. This waw is mad tabi'i. This ya mad tabi'i. This alif mad tabi'i. This waw before it dhamma. U. This ya before it kasra. O-T. This alif before da, fatha. O-T-na. Another example. Atujadilunani. Here the alif, mad tabi'i. The waw, mad tabi'i. Natural, original, self. The ya, mad tabi'i. Because the alif becomes before it fatha. And the waw before it the dhamma. And the ya before it the kasra. For that, this one and this one and this one, alif or waw or ya is mad tabi'i. If there is no hamza, there is no sukun before it. What should be before it? Before the waw, dhamma. And it is itself sakin. Suppose this is have a fatha. It will be nu wa. For that, there is no dham. There is no mad. Nu wa. For that, nu, hi, ha, u, ti, na. Now this has become mad because itself is a sakin. Itself with another way does not have any other haraka. Does not have fatha or kasra or dhamma. Does not have fatha or kasra or dhamma. Here the same. But the far'i is different than this one. Here there is no hamza or sukun, but al-far'i al-za'idu an al-tabi'i. Firstly, he is more than the tabi'i in lengthening. More than the tabi'i in stretching it. More than the natural one, because it will be, look here, 2 or 4 or 5 or 6. بسبب what? What is the reason? Hams or sukun. Hams or sukun. The reason of it, hamza or sukun. Here, this tabi'i one, have under it two different kind. With this one will be 3, because sometimes they count this one itself, the tabi'i, as number one. Then another two will be total three. Here, under this far'i, secondary, is 10 different kind. Miqdar, what the timing of it? How long you can stretch it? There is a rules also. Firstly, the way of stretching and the measuring of stretching, its name in Arabi, haraka. 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 In English, vowel counts. Haraka is vowel count. Equal to half second. Equal to half second. In the book, sometimes they will say to you, is like that, when you, if your finger is stretched like that, is equal to turned like this. Or if it is already like this, if you stretch it like this, this is named haraka because moving. But it is with the second, it is less than half second or equal to half second, every one haraka. There is some, it's named qasr, short one, which it is two haraka only like a tabi'i. It takes two haraka. Tawassut, the middle one, four haraka. Fuwayiq al-tawassut, over the middle, over the middle one. If you look at it, qasr, two. The longest one, ishba' means fulfill it completely, six. Two is the less one, six is the highest one. In between them, four. Higher than four, fuwayiq al-tawassut, which it is five. Again, short one is two. Longest one is six. In between them, the middle is four. Over the middle, because some of them you will find it is either four or five also. فوايق التوسط. Over the middle little bit, which it is five. This is two haraka, four haraka, five haraka, six haraka. Its name with the vowel counts, two haraka, which it is how many seconds? It will be 1 second, because every one haraka is half. Two haraka, it will be how many? Huh? 1 second. Four haraka, 2 second. Five haraka, 2.5 second. Six haraka is around 3 second. Around 3 second. This is very important to remember it and to know it and to repeat it for your own self as much as you can, because the coming depend on this one. What is the tajweed? What is the mad, the lengthening? What is the letters of al-mad? You have to know that it is only alif and waw and ya. How many kind of it? Now, the original one, al-tabi'i, is in the secondary. After, under everyone, there is some branches. We will be explaining with the detail. That the definition of al-tabi'i very important. The one does not, the reason of it is not hamza or sukoon. The reason of it is normally the sukoon of the sakin of the letter, and before it, the waw dhamma, before it, the ya kasra, before it, the alif fatha. Same. Before the waw dhamma, before the ya kasra, before the alif fatha. Same here also. Al-far'i, it is more than the tabi'i in lengthenings. Because of the hamza or sukoon, before or after the letter, the mad letter. And under it, 10 different kind. We'll explain, inshallah. Not all of them in one time. Even while I'm apply, I'll try. Ask Allah, give me tawfiq, say ameen. I'll try my best to go slowly, little by little, until we get used to something, it goes more. The timings of it, how long? It is counted by something, its name haraka, the measure of it, haraka. Which name in English, vowel counts. If you look here, vowel, V-O-W-E-L, counts. Which equal to every one, haraka is equal to half second. Less little bit or more little bit around, because nobody will be very exactly. It is three, one is qasr, short one. Ishba' or sometimes the name of tool. Ishba' means fulfill it. Or tall means the longest. Six haraka. Between the two and six, it is four, which in middle. Tawassut means middle. And fuwayiq tawassut over. Fuwayiq means over little bit of tawassut, which it is five. أقول قولي هذا وأسأل الله العلي العظيم لي ولكم التوفيق. And I